Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can download and install CodeBlocks IDE in Windows computer. The first thing that we have to do is we have to open up any browser that is installed in our computer. I have Microsoft Edge. I'm going to open that up. And then here in the address bar, we will enter the website address as codeblocks.org. And then we will open up the website. Here we can straight away see the download option. We will click on that. It will take us to this downloads page. Here we can see download the binary release. We will click on that. Now here we can see the CodeBlocks IDE is available for Windows, Linux and macOS. Depending on the operating system, we can see all the download options. Now here, since I'm using the Windows computer, I will go to this Windows download section. Now here, we can see a lot of download options. One important difference is that we can install the CodeBlocks IDE along with the C++ compilers, or we can install only the CodeBlocks IDE and it will not install the C++ compiler. Here, I will go with the second option, that is, I will install only the CodeBlocks IDE from this CodeBlocks website. I will not install the C++ compiler that is available with the CodeBlocks IDE here. Why? The reason for that is, when we install CodeBlocks IDE along with the C++ compiler, which is available from this particular website, we get older version of C++ toolset. If you want to use the latest version of C++ toolset, then you have to install the C++ toolset separately. I have already made a tutorial about how you can install the C++ toolset latest version. I will provide the link in the description box. All you have to do is pause this video here, watch the tutorial about installing the C++ compiler in Windows, install them, then come back to this particular video. And then continue from here onwards. Now here in this download options, if you see CodeBlocks, then the version number and then Mingw setup, it means that it will come with the C++ compiler. As I said before, I will not install that. I will install only the CodeBlocks IDE. And for that, we have to find a download option without this Mingw. And then apart from that, we can also see the options like only the setup.exe, setup non-admin.exe and no setup.exe. You can use the non-admin if you are not the administrator in your computer. You can use no setup if you don't want to, you know, install it by using the normal installation instructions, normal installation process. You know, it will extract the CodeBlocks files and then you can launch from that. And then finally, this setup.exe option, it will follow the normal process of installation where the CodeBlocks will be installed in the C drive. Now here, I will go with the CodeBlocks version number and then setup.exe. And here, if you're using 32-bit operating system, then you can find the download option below. Okay. So depending on whether you have 64-bit or 32-bit, you can go with the appropriate version. I have the 64-bit operating system and that's why I will go with this first option, CodeBlocks, and then the version number setup.exe. Again, this will not install the C++ toolset. I have already installed that in my computer. So I will install only the CodeBlocks IDE. Okay, now here we can download from any of these options. I will click on FossHub and here the download will automatically begin. If it doesn't begin, then you can see the download options below. You can click on these links and download the file. Now once the file is downloaded, we can see the option open file. We will click on that. If it asks for the permission, then click on yes and provide the permission. Now I will minimize the browser window and here we can see the setup window has been opened. We will click on next. We will agree the license agreement. We will select all these things, click on next, and then it will display the location where CodeBlocks will be installed, normally in the programs files folder in C drive. And then we will click on this install. It will extract the files and install them in our computer. Now after that it says, do you want to run CodeBlocks now? I will click on yes, and then I will click on next and finish here. CodeBlocks IDE will be opened. Now for the first run, it will automatically detect the compiler that is installed. As you guys can see, I have the GNU GCC compiler installed, so that is detected here. We will click on OK. Now it will open up the CodeBlocks workspace. Now here, if you want, you can associate the C++ source files with the CodeBlocks IDE. I will not do that. So I will select no, leave everything as it is, and then click on OK. Now what we can do is we can create a simple C or C++ project and make sure that everything works. I will click on this file and then new and then project. Here I will select the console application. I will click on go and then I will click on next. I will select C++ and then next. Now here I have to select the name for the project. I will say hello world. And then we have to select the folder where we want to save this file. I will save the project in my desktop. So I will select desktop in here. And then I will create a new folder. I will call it as CodeBlocks projects. You guys can select any folder. And then I will select this folder. Now, after that, I will click on next. And here we can see the compiler, everything is selected. After that, we will click on finish. Now in the management window, we can see the project hello world. And in this sources folder, we can see the main.cpp file. If I double click on that, this file will be opened here and it contains this simple C++ code, which will display hello world text on the screen. So in order to run this program, we will click on this build and then we will click on this build and run. Or you can press the F9 key in your keyboard. Now once I do that, the program will be compiled and it will run. A command window will be opened and here we can see the output of the program, which is hello world. So this is how we can download and install CodeBlocks IDE in a Windows computer. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.